All right, once again, ladies and gentlemen, let's have a very well-deserved round of applause for the incredibly talented Inetnung Gifpago chapters from Southern High School and GW. Now, what's something very, very worthy of note is they are under the very astute direction of a former KUAM CareForce honoree, the very talented Vicente Regis. Half a day and good evening, everyone. Welcome to the 2017 KUAM CareForce Honors Awards Ceremony. I'm pleased to be here. I'm Jason Salas.
And I'm Sabrina Salas Matanani. Tonight we are recognizing those individuals who've made a difference in our community in a variety of ways, whether in the area of health and wellness, our environment, our cultural preservation, service to those in need, and just being inspirations for others. We are proud to call these individuals our 2017 KUAM CareForce honorees for all they have done for our community.
And we are now in our sixth year, as the KUAM CareForce Honors is an extension of our community service initiative, the KUAM CareForce. Now, each and every year, we call upon our community to help us recognize individuals that share our values, as well as our passion for simply doing what we can to make our island community a better place.
Service to our community makes us who we are as a company, as a team, and as individuals. Here's a little more on the KUAM CareForce. Service to our community has been a vital part of our operation at KUAM throughout our more than 60 years in local broadcasting. The names and faces may have changed through the years, but our company has maintained this core value. We feel as a major influencer, it is our responsibility to raise awareness, lead by example, and of course, give back. At the turn of the new millennium, our creative forces aligned, so to speak, and we formalized our service efforts under the KUAM CareForce Community Initiative. The KUAM CareForce has been there for our community in times of need and disaster. To raise money and collect donations for local charitable organizations. To lend a hand. To do what we can to make our island a better place. Over the past year, we've organized community forums, braved the shave, and rallied record numbers of island residents to shave their heads in support of children's cancer research and assistance, banded together and participated in a variety of service activities from north to south on Giving Tuesday for our third annual Giving Marathon. And, of course, supported a variety of community partners for their annual events. We donate thousands of dollars in airtime to many worthy causes and lend our sponsorship to community events throughout the year. But the KUAM CareForce's service to our local community goes so much further. At KUAM, rallying together, volunteering, and encouraging our community at large to join us in making a difference is second nature. A call to service is at the heart of who we are as a team and as individuals, and what makes the KUAM CareForce a force of good within our community.
We got this, Mom!
Tonight, we are honored to recognize a distinct group of corporate partners who share a passion and commitment to our local community. Triple J Enterprises has been a supporter, an advocate, and a major benefactor to countless local organizations serving those in need. Here's more from a local business making a difference.
A love of community is one of Triple J's deepest values. And through forming partnerships with a litany of local nonprofit organizations, this group is linked to the community in very meaningful ways. Triple J founder Robert H. Jones has always said, "Let us all remember to put more into the pot of life than we take out, and leave some for those less fortunate." He and the Jones family have always believed in giving back, because everything belongs to the Lord, and that we are just temporary custodians and must always do the right thing. His words resonate within the company as they strive to build better communities. They've helped a long list of organizations with diverse but equally honorable missions and purposes. From youth sports such as the Guam National Football Federation and Guam Football Association, to health-based organizations like the Lupus Awareness Group of Guam the American Cancer Society, and Guam Cancer Care. Triple J has supported those in need with partnerships with the faith-based organizations Pacific Mission Aviation and Harvest House, as well as supporting the nurturing of our youth through partnerships with Junior Achievement, the Boy Scouts, the Guam Community College, the Guam Trades Academy, Father Duenas Memorial School, and the University of Guam Endowment Foundations, along with supporting cultural foundations such as the Filipino Community of Guam and the Guam Museum Foundation. They've also been a key corporate supporter of the American Red Cross and Guam Crime Stoppers, and have supported the Humane Society International in their effort to manage Guam's dog population. At Triple J, their Customers First slogan extends to the entire community and speaks to their passion about helping people throughout the community.
There aren't too many 12-year-olds who are already leading by example, but our hope for tomorrow, honor recipient, is just that. While others her age save money for the latest electronic device or fashion trend, she saved her money for those truly in need. I was fortunate enough to meet this inspirational young woman earlier this year. She also received our monthly Good Neighbor Award. I'm proud to introduce you to our 2017 KUAM CareForce Hope for Tomorrow honoree, Ysabella Legason. She truly embodied the spirit of Christmas, and she continues to warm our hearts to this day. Earlier this year, 12-year-old Ysabella Legason received KUAM's Good Neighbor Award. Today, she's back as our KUAM CareForce's Hope for Tomorrow recipient.
I donated a piggy bank to the church.
A piggy bank?
Yes.
And to Santa Barbara Church?
Yes.
Why did you do that?
Because I want to help people in need who needed money, or which are poor.
It was last Christmas Eve, just after midnight mass at Santa Barbara Catholic Church, that the preteen delivered her pink plastic piggy bank to the ministers without leaving her name.
After the mass, my dad helped me carry the piggy bank because it was heavy.
The mass celebrant that day was Father Dan Bien, who was so impressed by the generous donation, he had to find out who the mysterious little girl was.
When I returned to the sacristy, the ministers gave me this piggy bank. He said, and I asked them, where did you get this? I said, a little girl came and donated this to the church. And I asked them, did you get her name so we can thank her? No. So, and then I remembered, that was the following day or a day or two after, that we have the CCTV camera. So I said I might, you know, get to recognize her. So I reviewed the camera, the CCTV, and you know, it was a little bit blurred. So I decided to post it on Facebook.
The selfless little girl was quickly identified as someone close to the church. Ysabella already sings for the church's St. Cecilia Choir. This isn't her first time donating a year's worth of savings to a good cause. In 2011, she donated all the contents of her piggy bank to the Salvation Army bell ringers at the mall. Her donation too big to fit in the red kettle. Media reports that year totaled her donation to $100. Ysabella credits her parents, Stella and Vincent, for setting the positive example to teach her to give, even when you don't have much.
Because my mom or my dad told me that if you donate to the church, they give it to someone who's in need for food or other stuff, etc.
So please welcome to the stage Ysabella Legason to receive our Hope for Tomorrow Award. Do you want to say a few words?
I actually like helping people, so that's why I donated the pink. Hi!
Island Cancer Center is a proud corporate partner of the KUAM CareForce Health and Wellness Honor.
They are there for our island residents when many of them are most vulnerable and support organizations in our community that make a difference in prevention and support of this disease. Here's more.
Island Cancer Center is not just a business. We want to be involved with the local community so that we can best serve the community and to provide the best care to our patients. We support many events, community events, like the Relay for Life by the American Cancer Society and the events organized by the Guam Cancer Care and other health events in the local community. We support these events because organizations like the American Cancer Society and the Guam Cancer Care are providing very valuable services to our community. By providing the best care to our patients and participating in community events, we can help to promote health in our community. We feel that community service and support are very important because we are part of the fabric of the community and we want to make a difference in improving the health of the community.
When you think of fitness on Guam, Tony Sgro's name is top of mind. There is no doubt he's been successful in the fitness industry on Guam with Paradise Fitness Center now celebrating 20 years in business.
Anybody who knows Tony knows that promoting good health, exercise, and fitness is not just a wise business venture. It's a passion that fuels him. He's influenced so many in our community and provided the means for them to make healthy lifestyle changes, improving their quality of life, reversing diagnosis, and ending bad habits, all while doing it with a great big smile on his face.
His philosophy, exercise is medicine, is infectious. Tony and the staff of Paradise Fitness Center are also fervent supporters of many local organizations and community events, from leading 5K warm-ups around the island to participating in health fairs and so much more. Let's learn more about the 2017 Health and Wellness honoree, Anthony Tony Sgro.
If you walk out there in our facility right now, it's hanging on the wall, was the philosophy that I wrote 20 years ago. And up to this day, it holds, you know, as long as I own this company, that is the philosophy. I tell that to my son, who's gradually getting involved in the operation. And it was stated there, which was stated 20 years ago, Paradise Fitness is a place for everyone. Doesn't matter what size, what age, stipulated right there, and we're here for a healthier community. When I decided to go into this business 20 years ago, it was all about a healthier community. It's there, a healthier community. That's what gets me excited. When I'm walking through the facility and I see a guy with a zipper, and I call a zipper, I can see he just has an open heart. I can see the zipper coming up here. And he's there on his bike, getting his dose of medication. Because that's what his doctor said. He's got to keep his heart rate going. He can't go out and do it out in the sun. And he's there consistently. That makes me feel good. When I look at the cancer patient, and I see that cancer patient with her bandana on, young, in her 40s, you know, I said, you know what, I'm doing my job. You know, I am trying to do something for the community. And though it's a business, it is a business. It's gotta be run like a business. But that's what gives me also my dose of medication. It's a great honor. It's a great honor that they recognize how important the fitness and wellness is to our people of Guam. You know, and for myself, I think we've touched, you know, thousands of individuals from all walks of life. And as a community, I'm asking everyone in this industry, it doesn't matter, I don't look at any other, you know, I'm gonna call them, you know, the CrossFit boxes, you wanna call them, you know, anybody who's in this in this industry. And I wanna say, well, I was kinda like, you know, been in it the longest, but anyone who's in this industry, I've been asked, what do you think about all this competition? And I say, you know, I don't look at it, and I really don't look at it as competition. We all gotta come together. There's enough for everybody, number one. Number two is that our ultimate goal is to have a healthier community.
Now to help us present the award is Dr. Colin O'Connell of the Island Cancer Center. On behalf of the KUAM CareForce, we are so proud to present tonight the 2017 Health and Wellness Honor to Tony Sgro, Paradise Fitness Center. Now, I know Tony is going to want to say a few words.
Are you sure about that? Okay. All right, well, first of all, I want to thank the KUAM CareForce for this humbling nomination. But I'm going to make this really short and sweet. I really do believe when I say exercise is medicine. If there is a pill that a doctor could prescribe that can do all that exercise can do, it is the number one prescribed pill. And that's not Tony Sgro speaking, that's the American Medical Association speaking. Thank you very much.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the KUAM CareForce Think Green Honor is presented to an individual who fosters a sense of respect and care for our environment and action for a sustainable future for our island.
Our 2017 Think Green Honor recipient is more than just a steward of our environment. As the Guam Community College's sustainability administrator, he is someone that uses our resources and how we operate, build, develop, and grow. He has also led others to think in an environmentally conscious way through his coordination of several projects to include the Sustainable Technologies and Environmental Education Program and the Sustainable Technologies Clinic and Island Sustainability Awareness Program and the Green Dream Homes Competition.
And now here's more about our 2017 Think Green honoree, Francisco Kiko Palacios.
GCC has been doing like sustainability stuff even before they brought me into to the school. But it was a new position. And so it allowed me to take my creativity and, you know, let it flow throughout the campus, whether it be developing programs or different projects. You know, they kind of looked at me for advice on how we can do certain things. You know, the support that I get from the higher-ups, the president, directors, faculty, even the students is really what drives me. The support that they give me is I don't have the words to explain that. I didn't know I was gonna end up in this field, but after doing a few internships at Saipan, my hometown, under the Division of Environmental Quality and the Coastal Resources Management Office, I don't know, my eyes just opened up to this whole world of the environment and protecting the environment and also the environmental issues that surround us today. I started to see the bigger picture. And aside from recycling, I started, you know, getting into gardening, farming, reducing my use of different things. And also meeting different people who share the same passions as I do. They really encourage me, they really inspire me to be a better person in that respect. The most rewarding part of my job is just seeing that you're making a difference through the kids, through students. I've had several students kind of email me. There, some of them are in college already, and they've gone to pursue higher education in sustainability fields, in technology fields that relate to sustainability, or they want to do, you know, things, different hobbies related to sustainability. Seeing that, you know, the people that you've dealt with at one point or educated want to perpetuate that, and I think that's the main goal. And just seeing that they can influence other people to do the same, it really makes me happy because, you know, just the environment has provided so much for us.
The KUAM CareForce is proud to present our 27th Think Green KUAM CareForce honor to Francisco Kiko Palacios.
You know, when I first got the email, I was telling my friend that it said, congratulations, you're the health and wellness honoree. And, you know, I don't even go to the gym. But and then I got the corrected email, but I was actually expecting a third email that says, just disregard all the emails that we've sent you. But I'm so honored, honestly, to receive this award. It's really a surprise to me until now. I know that this is just one award, right, for one individual, but, you know, there's so many people to thank out there. There's so many people that have inspired me and encouraged me to do good for the community and good for the environment. So although I'm holding this award by myself, you know, I feel like all the other organizations like the Protehis, Undefending Guam groups, Guam Nature Alliance, the Protehi Retidian group, you know, they're all fighting the good fight, and, you know, we should join in and do good for the island, do good for the community. Thank you again for this award. I really appreciate it.
Good evening. Have a day. Buenas.
Buenas.
Viva Miss Tomorrow. I'm actually here to roast Tony Sgro tonight. Anyway, hey, good evening again. The where are we at here? Okay. Our next corporate partner is Docomo Pacific, whose very slogan, better together, mas malikid na mandanyahit, is a value that the community of solidarity, together means mandanya. We can all achieve more in making our community a better place to live.
Right, that's right. And they are a leader not only in the technological advances, they're also making in the way service is a central part of their operation. Here's more on Docomo Pacific.
Our brand and our corporate culture are built on a pillar of being one with the community. We believe that communication transforms lives, and we have the tremendous responsibility to serve the community through our resources, technology, and services. Each day, we deliver more than connectivity. We bring opportunities for people to connect, collect, explore, discover, like, love, and share. In turn, allowing us to fulfill our promise of connecting you and your loved ones closer to the things that matter most. Better Together is more than a tagline. It's a powerful call to action that engages our associates, community partners, and stakeholders to truly connect and be one with the community. Docomo Pacific Cares was created to activate and engage community outreach and public relations in Guam and the Sinai. Docomo gives back. It's activated during the holidays, and this helps to allocate resources for nonprofit organizations so they can continue to pursue their mission of serving our community.
The recipient of the 2017 Dai Kutura honor is a professor of Chamorro Studies at our own University of Guam. He is someone who is taking an active role in keeping our Chamorro language and culture alive and useful in our daily lives at a time when we are inundated with enormous amounts of competing pop culture influences. He works towards making the Chamorro language even more relevant to our younger folks, and I guess it's called now millennials. Through a variety of means, including social media, comic books, and free community classes at cafes. Though we refer to the Adahi Ekutura honor as one bestowed upon someone who prefers or preserves and promotes the language and culture, our honoree is comfortable and much more likened to the term of preservationists. And his goal is not to keep things stuck in time, but to use our language to grow in a more relatable for generations to come. Here's a look at our 2017 Adai Ikutura Honors recipient, Dr. Michael Megit Bevacqua.
Just a minute before you translate that to English and try and digest what just said. Malatabe wa pula no gifino itsamoru wa Dr. Miguel iporini CBSTE benti disisheti adain kultura na onda sa profesor estena kilisdaon ngi gati ye universidad Guahan. Brabos and matanga I nananonia estena tautau para ususteni I lingwahi tan kulturan itsamoru. Dengan mengajar lagu uga para mas bestamu negi tempu perata sedbi dan perata na sedbi mas isti finut samoru. Tiga bulan yang setengah kelas zano na pemafanaan negi sama gay po preserve givenu ing litera na banda isti lingua ing kultura lo para mas para azoni I paro poksai zata embrasa manginin manuit magi. Madafan pagoza ta atan isti lengnya si sino jasiluhan tatan di dede per ST na tau-tau si senior Dr. Miguel Bevacqua.
I made my grandparents speak to me in Chamorro, which they found to be very funny and frustrating for a long time. I was driving old people to funerals and like visiting old people in their homes and sitting down with old tape recorder, taking notes about them and their lives and what life was like before World War II. And so it was really kind of learning the Chamorro language that got me much more passionate about these sorts of things. I really have to thank my grandparents, in particular my grandfather, the late master blacksmith Jack Lujan, because he was really the one who gave me any sort of love or respect for the Kuturata. He was he spent most of his life making Chamorro tools, and then in the last 10 years of his life, he taught me and my brother how to make tools, in addition to other apprentices. And so. He really showed me that like culture is not simply about buying shirts, getting tattoos, that it requires this. You have to live it. And as he would say, you have to love it too, and you have to live it. And so he's one that really taught me that you gotta incorporate culture and language into your everyday life, and that's how you keep it alive. It's not because it's in a museum, it's not because it's in an article or something like that, but the more that we connect our culture in whatever form it takes to our everyday experiences, the more vital and alive it will be. Our culture is not just practices, it's not just words, it's not just recipes. The purpose of every culture is it's not just what your cult, what you do, what you've done before, but it is this force which is supposed to empower you and give you a sense of your place in the world, in history. And so for a long time, Chamorros kind of bought into this notion, Ta'adza Kotorata, we don't have any culture, este malingo todo, it's all gone. But now we're starting to see our culture differently again. Now we just have to kind of bring it into our everyday lives. So we see the way dancing is now part of our everyday life, where it wasn't for a very long time. You know, let's encourage carvers, canoe makers, navigation people, weavers. Let's encourage them, but also musicians and writers. Let's encourage all of them to keep creating, because that's how the Chamorro culture will be alive, is if our artists, our artisans, our masters, if we keep creating and keep teaching.
To help us present the 2017 Dai Cultura honor to Dr. Michael Miguel Bevacqua is Danny Daniel, brand manager at Docomo Pacific.
I'm going to see Danny Daniel for present este para ta honor ay 2017 Dai Cultura na honor.
Sidus masi jas and kin. Zatoros hamzu lokwe. Sidus masi parestina donkluna onra. Gimana gaya tu tiu merere siesti na donkluna ora lo hua gade. Husena gade siesti. Malagatuna be dedicate esti na in a premu para idos sidoku grandparents. Si Joaquin Flores, Lujani defunto, master blacksmith. Sa guidza magaya tumano esti na guenaitza para ikuturata zani lenguahita. Gidza guahu. Then I joku grandmother loqui si Elizabeth Flores Lujan. Sen mangi na biha sen mahaleng zu nu adzuna dos kada dia kololonia gi champu taiguini. Lo esti na mensahe malaguzuna besangani hamzu puri lenguahita puri koturata haha su esti engen un latla gifinut tomorrow un latla ifinut tomorrow. If we live in the Chamorro language, we give life to the Chamorro language. So, the more that we make it relevant for our lives, the more we make it interesting for young people and connect to what they value and they find fascinating in their lives, the greater the chance that it will live on into the future. This language has been around for 4,000 years, and only by doing stuff like that can we keep it alive for another 1,000 years. Sidzus masi.
Uh,
All right, everybody. The Selfless Service Honor is presented to an individual who has dedicated their time, energy, and skills to help those in need. To say these individuals have a passion for helping others would be, let's be honest, a massive understatement. Then this year's honoree, Bree, is certainly no exception.
As the executive director of the Special Olympics Guam, Frank Florig, works with the board of directors and community partners to provide sporting opportunities to more than 300 athletes with learning disabilities in our local community. They hold events at the Agatnya Pool, Central Lanes Bowling Alley, and most recently, their track and field event at Ukudu High School.
Now, we and our colleagues at the KUAM Care Force were privileged to attend and assist this year's event. And despite the rainy weather, the smiles from the athletes competing brightened up everyone's day, each and every one. To see Frank in action on this day, undeterred by these steady showers as provided by Mother Nature, it was a true inspiration and a testament to why he is such a worthy recipient of this honor. Let's now learn more about our 2017 Selfless Service Honoree.
Being the fourth oldest among 10 children, I was always trying to find ways to better the lives, if you will, of my younger siblings. And that's where it all started. I can't think of a better program to be involved with. It's the athletes. You look at them and you see them come out and you see them shine for this. Shine on the day of the track and field event. I mean, that's what Special Olympics is all about. What we do is we give them a chance to shine at least for a couple of days throughout the year. The biggest inspiration is with the athletes. I'm not sure if you've ever been to one of these events. We all come here on a Saturday morning to get together and watch them compete. They walk away at the end of the day with medals. We walk at the end of the day with smiles. So in the end, we're all winners. If we want to live in a better place, we have to be part of that. We have to be part of that solution and also part of that culture, giving back. And I encourage every child, every adult, every grandparent to come out and give back to your community. It's not how long or how much time you give. It's the satisfaction knowing you've changed some lives. Really not me, it's the board of directors. It all starts with the board of directors of Special Olympics and the parents and the athletes. I feel very surprised because I do my volunteerism strictly on the basis that I want to give something back to the community. And I've got three children and I've got two grandsons, and I want them to grow up in that environment that regardless of how successful they are, how young or old they are, they should always look forward to bringing volunteerism into the culture.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the KUAM Care Force, we are proud to present the 2017 KUAM Care Force Selfless Service Honor to our friend Frank Florig, and to present KUAM's Chief Marketing Officer, Eli Motch. Frank, congratulations. Frank, would you say a few words, please?
Sure. I would like to accept this. I'm really honored and humble that I was chosen for this award this year. And I'm accepting this award on behalf of my family. They've stood by me 12 years. My wife has picked up the slack. And many times while I was out doing volunteer work, she was at home making sure our children did their homeworks and get ready for school and stuff. Also, the board of directors, I've got four of them here tonight. They are an inspiration to me. Whenever we go into projects like track and field, we go in with zero budget. We've got to figure ways to feed at least 1,600 volunteers, maybe about 1,000 people that show up to include the athletes. And that's a real task. They help me, they keep me in line, because a lot of times I want to go and, you know, I want to have a fiesta. They say, Frank, we can't afford that. But them, every parent or sibling that's got to wake up in the morning and get that child with an intellectual disability or a physical disability prepared and ready to face the island and move on with their lives. And I think more importantly, the athletes we have and everyone on Guam that has volunteered whatever time they can to not only Special Olympics, but to better the lives of everyone in our community. Thank you.
Thank you, Frank. Congratulations.
Sidus Malasi, and congratulations to all of our honorees tonight. We hope that their examples inspire all of you to strive to make a positive difference in our community.
And we would like to conclude tonight's program with another performance from our friends at the Inetnu Gifhawa chapters from Southern High School and from GW.
Song is called Decalor, so hope you enjoy.
How do I be the love?
and gentlemen, thank you once again for being part of another amazing evening, another amazing year, and another amazing KUAM CareForce Awards ceremony. We truly enjoyed having you be part of it. And remember, if you have passion in your heart, if you love Guam, this will be you. On stage next year, we would love to recognize what you do for our island community. So, tell you what, I hope everybody has their cell phones and their cameras charged. So let's go get our honorees on stage, please, for a group shot. We would love to do that. Frank, Tony, Dr. Mike, Kiko, and Ysabella, please. And I've been checking, and Snapchat has really cool filters for the museum, so this will look fantastic. Let's get one with all of the recipients, and then we'll get one of the recipients and their families, and then also the recipients and the sponsors. And then it's free for all after that.